Hey guys, Anthony Nader with DeadOnHunting.com. As part of our continued series on filming your hunts, we're going to take you up to the next level of camera, which is the professional grade camera. And this is what we use to film the actual hunt. All right, so when we're whitetail hunting, this is the main camera that we'll use in the tree, whereas the DSLR we would have on us as well, but more for B-roll footage. This camera is probably like $3,500, so it's obviously, it's not like a starter camera. And what I'd like to do is more just review this level of camera and what makes it a professional type camera, rather than this one specifically, because I purchased this about 3 or 4 years ago almost now. So I don't even know if they still will sell this camera. It's now what they've done is they've come out with 4K, which is a much nicer picture quality with this level of camera. This records at 1080 and an AVC HD format. But the new 4K has, you know, it kind of takes a professional camera like this and it gives it a picture quality of a DSLR. The colors are more vibrant. And it's just much more clear. There's like very little to no grain. But this camera is really nice, and what you know really gives it, you know, the high-end features are the focus rings right here. This is your iris, your zoom, and your focus. And that really, when you're trying to take professional quality hunting videos, this is what you need as a cameraman, because when you've got the deer out there and you want to zoom, you don't, it also has these top buttons, but you don't want to be using, you know, these to zoom in and out. You really want to be able to get nice, you know, smooth zooming and focusing with these rings that are on the camera. When it's bigger like this, it makes it a lot easier. They make smaller cameras like this that are still of professional quality. And when they have, you know, the kind of the two things that set them apart will make it a professional camera are the zoom and focus rings and the iris ring. And then the other thing is the XLR imports, which are right here. Now, the lower-end cameras will have a stereo mini for your external audio, your microphones, your shotgun mic, or your lav mic, whatever you're using. And then, obviously, you've got your viewfinder here, which during the day can be pretty difficult because it's just a little LCD screen. And when the sun hits it, you know, it, there goes your video quality of what you can see. So a lot of times, you know, I'll use one of these, which is just a external display. This mounts up top here. You've got your HDMI cord, which will go and mount in the back right here. And this just gives you a much nicer viewing screen versus just this little screen here. It also comes with, you know, a hood that will attach to this, so it cut down a lot on your glare. Now, this camera in particular has a 20 times zoom. You can record up top here as well as down here. And the other thing that would set this professional camera apart is the battery. There's a battery release. This is a 6-hour battery. Now that's like 6 hours of runtime. With this camera, you don't ever turn it off when you're in the woods. You leave it on. Now you don't leave it recording, obviously, but you just leave the camera on, which does make a big difference when, you know, you've got a split second when the deer comes out or you're turkey hunting. So you can just leave the camera on the whole time and then hit record when you need to. Whereas a lower end camera, you know, if something that you're going to buy at Best Buy, it's going to be who knows how much, $400, $200. I don't know. They've got like maybe 1 hour. You know, and when you're hunting, you're gonna have a 3 hour sit. You know, those batteries, they're really small, they're real cheap. This, you know, which, you know, if you're just starting out, whatever, that's maybe that's what you use, and you buy extra batteries and that. But as far as, you know, this camera being able to have battery life, good focus and zoom, the XLR imports for your audio, as well as your other HDMI and USB mini inputs and outputs, that's what makes this a professional camera. Now also, you've got your right here, you've got some your audio setup, as well as on the side right here, all of your audio controls, which makes a huge difference if you're from the smaller cameras. I will pretty much run in auto settings on this during the day, and then when it gets down, you know, to crunch time later in the evening and first thing in the morning, it's great to set up. You can change the white balance, the gain, and the shutter speed by running it in manual. And this camera has like a 1.4 lux rating, which is how well it can see in low light. So it's, you know, it'll get it pretty good. I mean, it doesn't really get better than that. Now, this camera is obviously, you know, like I said, I bought it for like $3,500 a couple years ago, and now this year we're going to look to move up to the 4K. But, you know, this is something that after a couple years of hunting or whatever, if you get into it on a much greater scale, this is something that you'd be looking at. But this isn't a starter camera. They've got a lot of great starter cameras on Campbell Cameras Outdoors. There's a lot of great reviews out there on those, and we're gonna actually start reviewing a couple of those cameras just to see what, you know, what would be best for the entry level user, the guy maybe first year, second year, even a third year who's looking to get into a new camera. What's the best first camera to get for hunting, and then, you know, the next step up, and so on and so forth. That's what would make a professional camera. That's what, you know, the features that this has, and we look forward to bringing you guys some more reviews on some entry level cameras. So if you thought this was interesting at all, then please subscribe to the channel and comment below, and don't forget to check us out at deadonhunting.com. We've got some more of our hunting videos there, as well as some apparel and stuff like that that, you know, we try and bring you guys. I always have some fresh content there as well. So thanks for listening, and happy hunting.